Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to talk about the Z-Image Turbo model, and I'm going to compare it with the Flux.2 Dev model. The Turbo version is a distilled version of the non-distilled foundational model, and this is important. It's a distilled version. It's meant for consumer GPU. It's going to fit within 16 gigabytes of VRAM. I'm actually running this on a 12 gigabyte VRAM. Now it says here that it excels in photorealistic image generation. There's also text rendering, and this is bilingual English and Chinese, and instruction adherence. We can do 4 steps when generating an image, and it takes around 14 seconds for me. This is including loading of the model. Now, when comparing this to Flux, it takes about 172 seconds, which is about a 12 times increase. To get faster speed with Flux.2 Dev, you will need high-end GPU. For the Z-Image, you can actually run this on 8 gigabyte VRAM card. Z-Image Turbo is a 6 billion parameter model, while the Flux.2 is a 32 billion parameter model. Let's start with the basic prompt that we get from the workflow. I'll be using this simplified workflow where I have only a single section for the prompt. This prompt is going to go inside the Z-Image Turbo and then inside the Flux.2. Now, without changing anything, using the default settings that came with the workflow, this is what I got. We have the section at the top, big title, summer, and this one was generated, rendered correctly, and you can see the character is quite nice, but this is where things start to go downhill. We are supposed to have a bottle in here, but we can see the bottle is split into two. Bicycle here is broken in here. The chain is not connected. It did not get all the text correct. These small texts like youth, we are missing the Y. Tokyo became Yokyo, and then we have some gibberish in there. So how about we do a smaller resolution? This time it's a vertical aspect ratio. Once again, it was not able to generate the text correctly. Again, it cannot do a good basket, grapes, and a bottle in there. But this time, the face is also badly rendered. Okay, let's try again. This time, a landscape version. This time, it was able to render some of the text correctly. Big text is apparently able to do it. It's able to do youth and freedom. It was able to do Tokyo Street. And the word it could not render was issue. And obviously, we are having issue with the model right now. Now, to give it credit, this time the character is kind of nice. If we take a look at the background here, we'll see that it duplicated the vending machine. I'm not quite sure why the default prompt that came with the workflow is this one, like a complex one. I'm pointing this out because when we take a look at the blog post, they mentioned here that this model excels at producing photorealistic images. And when we're saying photorealistic images, it's mainly these portrait images. This is the type of photorealistic images that it excels at. I went ahead and chose a similar prompt. This time, I'm just doing a Colombian model. I have no complaint about it when it comes to the facial detail. This model excels at generating characters. Where I feel it's failing, probably because it's a distilled version and it's only 6 billion parameters. So I'm saying a golden light on the skin, and then I'm saying I want to have a fine film grain on it. But when we take a look at it, we don't have that golden color that I was looking for. There's no grainy effect on the character. So like I said, we are going to compare this with the Flux.2 Dev. Flux.2 Dev is able to follow the prompt better. It was able to give me that yellowish golden color, and there's also that filmy, grainy effect that I was looking for. I would say that Z-Image is better at generating the characters. You can see here that I wanted clips in the hair, so I have one on this side, one on that side, and the version for Flux is stupid in my opinion. Sorry for that, but what is that? It feels like it's a zipper on the head. So although the color grading is good, I have that grainy effect. It completely destroyed the image. It's just that the Z-Image Turbo model is not flexible enough to add certain mood, certain effect to that image. Oh, by the way, in case you're wondering, how did Flux do with this prompt that came with the Z-Image Turbo model? Here is the image that Flux gave me. Have the summer, have all the text perfectly written. The character is great. There's also this shine in the back, kind of a dramatic effect. Take a look at the basket here. We have everything. But if we pay attention here, we'll see that Flux just cannot render hands correctly. I think when it comes to text rendering, Flux has an edge. When it comes to prompt understanding, especially when it comes to complex prompt, Flux has an edge. When it comes to generating characters, well, it's kind of hit and miss. I would actually go with the Z-Image Turbo when it comes to generating characters portrait. Here I'm doing realism. This is your amateur street photography. The top section is Z-Image, bottom section is Flux. Once again, we see a clear distinction between the colors and saturation of the images. It's only when we start to look into the background that we see things. Characters are going in the wrong direction. It also did not follow my prompt correctly when it comes to the color, the saturation, the grading. Whereas in the Flux version, it was able to generate everything, including that little vignette on the side here. But still, the Flux has an issue. It just generated a strange image. And if you take a look at the background here, it's way too chaotic. For my second prompt, the indoor one, I clearly mentioned here that I want a warm tungsten orange-like cast. I also want a soft blur, slightly noise from the low light sensitivity. And then I want a messy, cluttered desk. Here's what Z image generated. While it got the character correct, everything else is wrong. And here's the Flux version. To give it credit, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the thumb. So that's pretty good. It was able to generate the hands this time. It got all the elements correct. The atmosphere, that orange cast that I wanted. Right here, we have a bright screen and we can see that there is a highlight on the face. There's also highlight in the clothes. So this is a clear winner for me. The Z image is able to generate the character, but it's kind of failing when it comes to the environment. Here's another one. I want to test some professional setting. Here's a studio portrait. Then I have a fashion editorial section. You can see the character is well done. Just because I said I wanted to have softbox light, it added the softbox in the background. Here is the Flux version. It was able to generate everything. The backdrop gradient is perfect in there. I think Flux has an edge in this case as well. This one, it looks good if we don't know the prompt, but if you compare it with the Flux version, you can see there is a clear winner here. And my main complaint here is this last part, cinematic color, where I want a color grading of teal and orange. We don't have this. While in this one, it's that cinematic look. We have the teal and the orange color. We also have the color reflected on the character clothes. This one is a clear winner for Z image simply because we have hands in the image. Every single character in here, they have correct hands. While Flux was not able to do it, all the hands are pretty much messed up in here. Here's a close-up portrait. If you take a look at the skin, the lips, it's well done. But the moment we add the prompt to it, that is when we start to see that it did not generate what we were asking it for. We got pretty much everything related to the woman. And well, it's missing the shallow depth of field with individual hair strands. Take a look at the second one, where I asked for a pair of hands tying the shoelace, natural morning window light. I think this one, it generated it perfectly. Now, of course, I did a test with Flux. Bottom is Flux, same prompt. And Flux was able to get everything. We have the freckles, we have the shallow depth of field. We can see that one eye is in focus, the other one is not. There is this section here that shows part of the hair, and we can see individual hair strand. If I were to select between one of these two, I would take the bottom one. By the way, Flux was able to generate the hands correctly this time as well. Now, I thought maybe the prompt was too complex, so I tried to have some action in the prompt, but keeping it short. So character running towards camera, you have this Dutch angle, slightly tilted. There is rain-soaked pavement, neon reflection. Now, this is what Z Image Turbo gave me. It looks pretty good, right? We have that angle, that Dutch angle camera shot. There is reflection at the bottom, so it signifies rain. There is a little bit of neon, not too much. The character is running. Now, let's take a look at the version that Flux.2 Dev generated. I would personally choose the bottom section in all three versions. Here, I have everything. There is this sense that the character is really running fast here. There is the neon glow as well. I think Z Image has a problem with doing that color, clearly saying golden hour sunlight hitting the hair. We see a little bit here, but in the Flux version is slightly better. This example here best illustrated. I'm asking for a scene where on the left side, I want it to be red, signifying fire. And then on the right side, it's supposed to be blue, with ice. We see red here, but if you take a look at the red dragon, we have this bluish color which is bleeding onto the dragon here. And take a look at the Flux version, we have everything that I wanted. There's no bleeding. Once again, you can see that clear separation in the Flux version, where on one side it's this yellowish color, on the right side is this bluish color. But while it was able to generate the jacket as yellow, we have a little bit of yellowish here. It's not looking great. It doesn't have a distinct separation that I was looking for, like this one. Same thing here, adherence when it comes to complex prompt, Flux takes the lead here. I wanted two scenes, one day, one night, and we have this clear distinction here. There's a gradual change between the day to night scene compared to this one, but it did not do it exactly in the middle, which feels off when you look at the image. Just so that you know, you can do anime characters. I was trying to see if it would be able to do the front, a side view, and a back view. It did the front view. Well, the side view is not entirely correct, and the back view is, well, it's messed up. It can do black and white, although it does not quite understand what is supposed to be black and what is supposed to be white. There's slight bleeding of the colors. Once again, it can do this type of cartoony watercolor effect. And I asked for an American version, and it generates not safe for work image. I'm not sure if this model is uncensored, if it can do not safe for work. Okay, let's talk about text rendering. We talk about text rendering a little bit here, but when your prompt main focus is the text, I feel like it can do pretty much everything. So I have these four here, which were all generated using the Z-Image model. Experimental Future Design 2045 was generated correctly. Just for curiosity, I decided to test out these two with Flux as well. And if you take a look here, we can see that we have a clear winner if we had to choose between these two. I don't think someone would prefer the top part where it's plain, it does not have texture in that notebook, while this one is way better. And here's the Sunny Morning Bakery version. This one I asked for two different fonts, and it was able to generate two different fonts here. By the way, you can do food, you can do product display, you can do these scenes. There are different styles of watercolor, there's pixel, there's fantasy, there's cyberpunk, there's also cinematics when it comes to characters. When you have this long descriptive text that is doing multiple things, I have the top section which is giving an overall description of what I want to happen. And then on the left side, I'm describing what I want. So left side is supposed to be a reflective surface. Center one is supposed to be a holographic cube inside a transparent glass. And then the right side, where we get texture with different colors. Z-Image Turbo here gave me all three elements, but when you compare it with Flux version, then we start to see there's a couple of things which are missing here, which were rendered wrong. And the first thing, in the reflective surface, we don't have that reflection that I was going for. Flux was able to do it. We even have this neon glow in the reflection, which is a nice touch. And the holographic text, clearly it's wrong. I want the text to be inside the cube. When you compare it to the version that Flux did, we can see that the S is split into two because of this edge. We also see it there at the top in between R and H. Now, this section, honestly, I feel like when it comes to colors, it's not doing great because there are no colors in there. And if you take a look at the Flux version, now we can see there are colors there. So this is what I wanted. This is what I got. Is it a good model for text generation? Yes, it's a very impressive model for the size, for this super lightning speed that we're getting. On my system, it's 14 seconds. This beats all the other models that we've seen so far. This is really impressive speed. The quality is really good for these portraits when it comes to characters, but for slightly more complex prompt, more professional, when you want to have that glow or that color in there, then I feel like it's failing. When it comes to generating text, if the text is the main focus, this here was generated using the Z-Image Turbo, so no complaint there. When the text is part of something bigger, especially when the prompt is too much, it does make mistakes. So I think right now, if you keep your expectation to generating portraits, then you're going to get a really good result. Landscape as well, it's pretty good. So that's it. That's my review on this model, comparing it with Flux.2. All right, thank you for watching until the very end. Let me know what you guys think. If any of these you don't agree with me, let me know. We can always discuss it in the comments down below. I'd like to say a big thank you to everyone supporting the channel on Patreon. Thank you to all for watching until the very end. Have a nice day. Take care. I will see you next time.